though it may take time to discover it. So certainly when I first started to practice, you know, I felt rather strange about the idea of it. In fact, the first time I chanted Nam-myoho-renge-kyo, I did it in secret when no one was looking. I felt so embarrassed about sitting, elderly gentleman, age 50 at the time, sitting or kneeling in my room and chanting Nam-myoho-renge-kyo. But actually, for me anyway, when I first did it, and I did it, as far as I remember, for about a half an hour, first time I did it, it was an extremely profound and deep experience, which I could never forget, and which, of course, absolutely, totally influenced my whole life for the better. So, whatever happens when one tries it, one needs to be, of course, serious. Though you don't understand it, your trusted friends maybe say, this thing works. This thing, you know, is changing my life for the better. So something stirs and you do it. Perhaps only for a few minutes, but you do it sincerely and without a shadow of doubt. Immediately, though it may not be apparent at once, effects are taking place in your life which will become manifest comparatively quickly. This is the truth of it. People discover so quickly that this practice works for themselves. And of course, no one on earth can make one do it by force. Really, Nichiren Shoshu Buddhism is a do-it-yourself Buddhism. So, whilst we practice, as you know, we have beads which we use to help concentration. There's nothing holy or sacred about the beads, in fact. Though, of course, they become part of one's life when we use them a lot. But, in fact, the beads represent the fact, you know, that life is in your hand. You place them on your two hands in this way, and place the palms and fingers together in the natural state of prayer. And this represents life in your hands. Here are your head and two arms, and here's the two legs, and you cross them in the middle, representing the waist, and each bead is one of the 108 desires which are taught in Buddhism as being inherent in life, and I'm certainly not going through them all now, and I couldn't anyway from memory. And also here, there are four small beads, which the qualities of purity and eternity, life force and strength and wisdom, which comes from the actual practice. In fact, of course, there are more formal meanings. Three tassels, in fact, are the Buddha, the law, and the priest, the three treasures as they are known. But I won't go into that now. What I want to emphasize is that this is representing that life is in your hands and no one else's. If one practices as the Buddha taught, then great benefit will come. If you don't practice as the Buddha taught, that is your decision. So also, the bringing of the hands together represents the mutual possession of the 10 worlds. Remember, we were talking about this last lecture, that each of those 10 states of life in itself contains the 10. In other words, even a Buddha has hell, hunger, anger working in him. Just as a human being in hell has Buddha in him. This is a very important principle because it shows clearly that the Buddha is a human being and that human beings all have Buddhahood. So that is what this position represents. So this is how we practice, alertly, sitting up straight, chanting the words clearly and resonantly. not shouting them, and not whispering them. After all, these words are expressing the rhythm and force of life. So naturally, they should be firm and clear, dynamic, perhaps is the best word to use, and very rhythmical. And through that, as we chant Nam-myoho Renge-kyo with our mouths, hear it with our ears, at the same time, in our minds, we are concentrating on our prayers, on our desires and wishes, for the betterment of ourselves, and also for the happiness of other people. So Buddhism relates practice for yourself and practice for others as an absolute necessity or part of the rhythm of life itself. If we practice for ourselves only, we'd not be in rhythm with the natural rhythm of life. Equally, if we practice for others only, we would not be in rhythm. The rhythm of life is both to nurture oneself, isn't it? As well as to nurture others. We can be of little use if we're a pathetic, scarred, battered plant ourselves. At the same time, how could we, you know, impress anybody else? We have to have strength, life force, and a vibrant life in order to influence our environments, and indeed to have the strength to help others. So it's a two-way thing, and this is the very nature of life. So I think I've said quite enough, and I've also gone on rather a long time, but I hope that that's sort of beginning to become clear to you. And there's still, if you like, perhaps 5 minutes. If anyone has a burning question, please don't hesitate to ask. Has anyone got anything particular that has puzzled them about what I've been saying? All right. Okay, well, what I suggest is, just in case some of you have not heard the chant, that those members who are here now, we'll just turn and face this blank wall and chant Nam-myoho Renge-kyo 3 times, and you'll all hear what it's all about. Maybe a little more than 3 times so that people can hear the rhythm of it, right? Would you start with that?
Nam-myoho
Maybe one of the members here can tell me the date of it. I haven't got my program on me. But the next lecture is on the Gohonzon. That is to say, the actual object of devotion or scroll, known as the Gohonzon. And that will be on... Anyone know? Anyone got their schedule? which again? 9th. 9th of December. Thank you very much. Okay.
Many thanks.